Everybody seems to be ready. Are you ready? For the first time in 3 years, the greatest rock and roll band in the world, the Rolling Stones! The Rolling Stones!
We're gonna have a look at you. We're gonna see how beautiful you are. Oh, New York City, you talk a lot. Let's have a look at you. Let's have a look at New York City. Woo! Well, all right. Welcome to the Breakfast Show. Charlie's good tonight, isn't he? I think you really dressed up tonight. I think we'd like to see how you look. Can we see how they look? Let's have a look how they look. Come on. just starting to see how they look. Wow, we couldn't see you. We couldn't see you.
It's really hard to see this together, isn't it?
It'll take time.
What?
8 weeks.
8 weeks. You think you can do it that quick?
This gives us a freedom. All you guys watching us. We may only be on you for a minute. Then go to almost anything.
This is Stefan Ponick, KSAN Radio, San Francisco. Well, the Rolling Stones' tour of the United States is over. They wound it up with a free concert at the Altamont Speedway for more than 300,000 people. There were 4 births, 4 deaths, and an awful lot of scuffles reported. We've received word that someone was stabbed to death in front of the stage by a member of the Hell's Angels. Nothing's confirmed on that. We were there. We didn't see it. But we did see a lot. We want to know now what you saw. Our phones are open. We'd like to hear from you. What was the Altamont free concert like?
The Angels did as they saw best in the difficult situation. Mm-hmm. As far as I'm concerned, they were people who were here who tried to help in their own way. Right? You know, if people didn't dig it, I'm sorry.
That was Sam Cutler, one of the organizers of the Altamont free concert. I think we've got one of the Hell's Angels on the line, Sonny Barger. If I got that right, Sonny?
Yeah.
Okay, what's up?
I didn't go there to police nothing, man. I ain't no cop. I ain't never gonna ever pretend to be a cop. And this Mick Jagger, like, put it all on the Angels, man. Like, he used us for dupes, man. You know, and as far as I'm concerned, we were the biggest suckers for that idiot that I can ever see. And you know what? They told me if I could sit on the edge of the stage so nobody would climb over me, you know, I could drink beer until the show was over. And that's what I went there to do. But you know what? When they started messing over our bikes, they started it. I don't know if you think we pay $50 for them things or steal them or pay a lot for them or what. Ain't nobody gonna kick my motorcycle. And they might think because they're in a crowd of 300,000 people that they can do it and get away with it. But when you're standing there looking at something that's your life and everything you got is invested in that thing and you love that thing better than you love anything in the world and you see a guy kick it, you know who he is. You're gonna get him. And you know what? They got God. I am not no peace creep by any sense of the word. And you can call them people flower children and this and that. Some of them people was loaded on some drugs that it's just too bad we wasn't loaded on because they come running off of the hill yelling, ah, you know, and jump on somebody. And it wasn't even always jumping on angels. But when they jumped on an angel, they got hurt.
Well done, Sonny. I think I remember him. Do you?
No, I'm not certain. I don't really remember what he looked like.
Because there was a couple of them before we went on. They were really very nice, you know. A couple of them guys. It just... I don't know. I mean, the way they cleared the path, for instance, was incredible, man. Were you there? Was you in that? In the party that had to be led to the stage? My goodness.
I saw what they did, yeah.
That was insane. That's just the way they did it, you know. It's very, very... Because before that, I didn't really think there was anything going on, you know, really. I mean, I didn't hear anything because we were right at the side. Oh, dear, what a shame.
KSAN Radio here. The violence at Altamont was completely unexpected. The Rolling Stones had performed for overflow audiences without incident in major cities across the United States.
Okay, baby.
We'll be right back. to keep me satisfied. I wanna get home with the Lord. Satisfaction from you, babe. And I want some satisfaction from you. And I want some satisfaction from you, babe. And my brother, I'm gonna get it. Now, mama, I'm gonna get it. I believe I'm gonna get it. I believe I'm gonna get it. I believe I'm gonna get it.
Sexually or philosophically?
Both.
Yeah, we're more satisfied now, sexually.
How about philosophically and financially?
Financially dissatisfied, sexually satisfied, philosophically trying.
Rubbish.
There's a questionnaire on the right, Rick. I read in one of the papers that you've been giving a free concert in San Francisco.
We are doing a free concert in San Francisco.
When?
On December 6th. And the location is not Golden Gate Park, unfortunately, but it's somewhere adjacent to it, which is a bit larger. It's creating a sort of microcosmic society, you know, which it sets an example to the rest of America as to how one can behave in large gatherings.
This is Mel Belli, the lawyer in San Francisco. I'm talking for the Rolling Stones. We've got their managers and their principals here. I've just heard that you've offered them your Speedway up there for their performance on Saturday. Is that right?
That is correct.
But this is an open phone, so we can all talk on it. What I'm trying to find out is what we can do to
now,
do this concert.
For the last 36 hours, I've stood my organization on its ear, Mr. Belli.
You see, I don't know anything about this. I'm just coming in late, and I'm trying to straighten something out. So you tell me exactly what it is without...
My first area of policy concern. I do not want this gesture on the part of Mr. Jagger to cost me 5 cents. If a blade of grass is torn down, they are going to build it up again. You know, I was involved in Woodstock. I have represented rock groups, and I've been involved both as an attorney and as an executive with festivals. No matter what anybody tells you, they're a pain in the ass.
Well, don't turn me into a proctologist. Just tell me what I can do here.
Look, somebody tell me why I should want to get this concert going.
Are you trying to make it so that they can't do this?
Not at all. I want it to happen, but I'm not prepared to have to rebuild my goddamn racetrack.
Well, let me ask you this. Will you come up and see if you can work with me on this thing? What time?
I'd love to work with you, Mr. Belli, but are you working with Mr. Jagger?
I haven't met Mr. Jagger yet. I've only met these other people here.
Have you met Mr. Schneider?
Yes, he's right here in the office.
All right, fine. He knows what happened at our meeting this afternoon.
Well, all right, then call me back and with the thought, see if you possibly could come up tomorrow morning and you and I can sit down and see what we can do with this damn thing.
Okay.
All right, call me back.
Okay.
Okay.
There's no way to do the concert but in that location. And as it stands right now,
you're going to have a lot of people.
You're going to have at least 100,000 kids there by Saturday morning.
You don't have any alternative. The only thing you can do is to do an affidavit and a temporary restraining order and talk to one of the judges. So that brings us down to this. I'll call one of the judges right now.
Is that your
only chance of forcing these people to do it? Now, don't scare off these people. If I were advising them, I'd tell them to hide out.
When they're coming out,
you'll hit. Stop, boom.
Okay. Yeah, but that's there. It doesn't come into the solo.
No, I know.
What is that?
What?
It's
a
canary pocket.
Cousin
Minnie Thank says, how delicious.
How delicious. How delicious. Proud
I'm taking
it
over rubber.
Y'all come back next year.
That's one more song.
You got the move.
Childhood living is easy to do. Things you wanted, I bought them for you. Don't have much time.
everybody in? Is my local group in? Hello, darling. How are you?
Where are the bags coming up, Ronnie?
When they all
get
there.
Stu's got to get 46 pieces up.
We're gonna do a slow blues for you now, people. I wanna
like that. Don't you like it? What's that? Oh, no.
Thing is going on. The Chronicle's coming out with a story tomorrow that it's off.
This has been building up for a long time. Off and on, off and on.
Everybody wants a piece of the pie.
Right, with all the information.
Let's see if we can get some facts built together on an affidavit here. And so that we'll have that available, and then a very short order to show cause. Sheriff wants to know who's going to go to the bathroom and where. They've got a nice little bucolic community there that they know practically when every John is flushed and the orderly habits of the bathroom of all of their voters.
Dick Carter's on the line. He's offering us a speedway at Altamont.
Hello? Dick, this is Mel Belli for the Stones. If they were to perform in the speedway, is the speedway open so that they can be seen from the people that can't get in?
Yeah, and I'm sure we can work something out because I want the publicity.
You want the publicity? Well, you take the publicity, and the Rolling Stones don't want any money. It's for charity, so I'll take the money.
Right.
All right. Well, why don't I do this? Why don't I talk with these people here, and then I'll get back with you, and then if we have to sign anything up, and if you need any insurance, which I'm sure you will want, and all the rest of that stuff, I'll work with you in the morning.
Okay.
All right. Well, I'll call you back later, then, after I talk with them, Dick. Bye. He's offered the Altamont Speedway.
There's not enough room
for it. And there's no time to move it. You got to tear down a stage and a scaffolding.
We've got stage scaffolding.
The phones are in. The generators are there. Everything is left to go. It's anticipated that the amount of kids now traveling cross-country, you may have anywhere from 5 to 20,000 kids starting to arrive sometime through the day tomorrow.
They're all lining up at the airports to come in from as far away as New York.
Yeah. Now?
Yeah.
You got to be kidding.
You have no idea what goes on here. It's an amazing phenomenon. It's like the lemmings of the sea.
Mike Lang is on the line.
Yeah, Mike. John says that he doesn't think you can make it over there at the Altamont Speedway. Do you want to talk directly to Mike?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah, Mike. I got the impression from everybody over where you are that there was no way of moving to that speedway.
We could do it. If we have to, we can. Nobody wants to, but if we have to, we can.
Just a quick question, though. You were at Woodstock, and you've now been out to Altamont, right, last night. Now, how does it stack up? Do you have the room?
I think we have the room, sure. I think we can hold as many people as want to come.
Can you change locations that fast?
Well, we had a much bigger operation to change at Woodstock. We did it pretty quick. I don't think we'll have much problem.
We're just dealing with a free concert. That's what we want to present. And I think that's what the Stones are up to. They want to play, and they want to play here.
Is this going to be Woodstock West?
Well, it's going to be San Francisco.
Do you have any special feelings about this kind of a concert, the spontaneous, free?
Well, it's not so much, I don't think it's the concerts. The concert's just the sort of, I think the concert's an excuse. You know, because, like, the thing is, it's just, like, everyone coming and having a good time, and the concert's not actually the proscenium of a theatre. It's, like, an excuse for everyone just to sort of, you know, get together and, like, talk to each other and sleep with each other and bawl each other and get very stoned and just have a nice night out and a good day, you know. And, I mean, you know, do you understand? You know,
I do.
It's not just like getting out there and seeing the Grateful Aeroplane and the, you know, sort of rolling dead.
I've been.
And now, I can Tina Turner.
Thank you. Loving you. Stop now. You watch out. Huh? Oh, I know you're tired. And you wanna be free.
And baby, I'll buy everything you want me to buy.
'cause you got what I want. 'Cause you got what I want, and you got what I need. And baby, you got what I need.
And I want you to give it to me.
And I want you to give it to me.
Make me say,
oh, baby. If you just stay with me and make me say, oh, baby.
It's nice to have a chip occasionally.
I think I bust a button on my trousers. Hope they don't fall down. It's that jumping around, man. I have to do it up again. You don't want my trousers to fall down now, do you?
We're gonna kiss you goodbye, and we leave you to kiss each other goodbye.
Hello.
Yes, Mel.
Yeah, we still have you.
Yeah, I got you in an echo. You think you can pick it up?
Well, I'm practicing. I'm going on first before the Rolling Stones. I'm testing my voice.
Can we get you to pick up the phone like before?
Okay. Well, what it is now, we're waiting for Mr. Carter to come in, but he has. I've just had a letter read to me where he said that he very definitely wants the Stones and the concert there. So, as of this minute, we're intending that the show go on. They have 200-300 people working, and it's going to be quite a problem to get the thing set up over at the Altamont Speedway, but it will be, and it will start at 10 o'clock. Now, that's where we stand. I'm waiting for Mr. Carter now. Let me ask and see, are the Rolling Stones all in town?
No, they're not yet. They're coming
tonight. They're coming in tonight. But everybody's ready, and they're all set to go. That's where we are. Is this Mr. Carter? Sheriff, Mr. Carter just came in. Now, could we talk a little bit? I can put this on the box so that we can all hear. And I think to start, Mr. Carter has expressed his willingness to have this on his private property over there. But the question is of this narrow road to come in there. Do you foresee any problems on that?
Well, that basically is the Highway Patrol's problem, and they foresee problems.
Uh-huh.
How many cars can Mr. Carter park on his property?
150 cars per acre. 150 cars per acre times 80 acres.
How many?
150 times 80.
12,000.
12,000 automobiles.
Well, up in Tuolumne County, they estimated they had 80,000 cars. What are we going to do with them?
It's a much open area around there. I can probably arrange with some of the other landowners. There's one adjoining me that has 2,000 acres.
Yes, well, we have some of the adjoining landowners complaining before it's even granted. There's 50,000 cars that Mr. Carter can't park. We're in trouble.
KFRC, this is Frank Terry, and let me repeat, the Rolling Stones free concert is going to be on tomorrow at the Altamont Speedway. Apparently, it's one of the most difficult things in the world to give a free concert. As you all know, first, the concert was originally scheduled for Golden Gate Park, and then at the Sears Point Raceway, they copped out. Many, many volunteers went out to Sears Point in trucks, cars, trailers, everything. Packed up all the gear out there and took it over to the Altamont Speedway, where they are right now at this very moment in the cold 30-degree weather, setting up the stage, setting up the generators, the sound equipment, and the facilities for the people. We'll be right back.
coming now. Oh, Mickey, 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 Mickey.
So long. I can't function. You know, I've been on the scaffolding almost all night. Look at, I can't close my hands. They are formed with the shape of the scaffold.
The people that are hanging on that scaffolding, you're rendering that scaffold unsafe by climbing on it. Those scaffoldings are not built to take very heavy weights. So if we could have some sort of reason, whatever that might be, we'd be very pleased.
Arthur, in between moving around, always turn that thing off. Turn it off and turn it on. Look at it, you gotta be very cool with that little thing. It's very weird. Even though it's supposed to be electrically correct, man, you gotta really think right around it.
You gonna hear some music today?
Hey, you want me to just leave us in here?
No, I want some. God's bananas.
Hashish, LSD, psilocybin. Hashish.
We're not going to, like, over here. Just park around. Make them as comfortable as we can. Like, even this parking situation shit back here, it's all wrong, but that's where the kids park. For once, we're just going to let it happen. Just for no other reason, for experimental purposes, you know what I mean? So be as easy on this as we can.
Yeah,
no matter,
no,
it won't hurt the stones in any way.
Wow, but I want to be smart, but you're just so far out. Because, yeah.
They should be back in a minute when they discover we're not with them. Since we got the beer and all the food, they'll find us.
Well, the guy's freaking out over the tent there, and,
Tough shit.
What do you mean, tough shit? The guy is really freaking out.
Actually, I don't mean tough shit. What I mean is that if you lay successive numbers of bummers on this crowd,
anyway.
By the time 6 o'clock comes, man, they are going to be in a real mood. I'm not prepared to stand here laying just...
All right, well,
bum trips
up at,
on 150,000 people all the time.
This was done, and you were there, and you know, and announcements were made.
We just started getting there, basically, if we make it at all. I've been falling a lot lately. Let's go this way. As a matter of fact, there's already a doctor over there, but the chick's having a baby. She's having a baby. Contributions for Panther Defense Fund. Contributions to the Panther Defense Fund. They're trying to either wipe out the Panther Party by jailing all the members and wiping them out economically, financially, or violently through killing them. After all, they're just Negroes, you know.
Need that cannon Y pretty bad.
We just had our first baby born at Dick Carter's Alamo Speedway,
yes,
Mike.
Yes, yes.
Just had our first baby born.
Oh, wow.
Okay, so far, everything's all right. We have a helicopter standing by if they need it for us.
Can we get a mic?
Yeah. If the press will push this Dick Carter's Altamont Speedway, not just Altamont Speedway, Mike.
Oh, this cat right over here, man. He just told me to do it, man.
No, well, I'm sorry. Nobody else chose to do it except me. I look after myself, and I'd really like you to get off the stage, baby. Please.
Okay, well, I can dig that, man, okay. You know.
Thanks very much.
Backstage, so that we'll never
well,
get.
That's going to have to be cleared out because the equipment's got to come in. Right. But as far as.
Well, what we need to do is start right getting some kid blokes together.
Well, the essence of the thing, as far as I'm concerned, is because this is where the work has got to
right.
go.
Right, well, that's the final
out.
Thing. Of
just
course.
Just sling them all out. The whole right. fucking issue, just say, don't know fucking about, we've had enough of being polite, right. get out, go away, please.
I'd have to.
That's what we've done.
Know.
So
stage.
If you could help us do
sure.
that, that would be right. groovy. All these people there, right? They're all.
I want to see Mick Jagger, goddamn. No!
Hey,
well, you go away, man.
Don't tell me what to say.
I'm
okay.
Tell you what
to say,
man.
Get on with your job, baby.
I'm trying to do
mine.
My job, man. You're trying to stop me, man.
Well,
I'm trying to ask you, will you ask all these camera
right.
people that are milling around here okay. if they move to the side of the stage, man?
We need a doctor under the left-hand scaffold as soon as possible, please.
They're not going to play music till we get a doctor. Somebody help. Somebody's hurt. Doctor.
Outside. I want to, you know. But I can't get very far.
There are a number of people on and around this stage who should not be here. Consequently, the musicians on this stage are playing with something like 200 people breathing down their necks. Now, can I please ask that everyone leaves the stage, and as I say, we'll go back to playing music and nothing else.
The Jefferson Airplane. Jefferson Airplane.
Other side of this line, yeah. Other side, go baby. I don't know what I'm doing. have here.
Hey, man, I'd like to mention that the Hells Angels just smashed Marty Ballin in the face and knocked him out for a bit. I'd like to thank you for that.
There's other ways.
Hey, wait, you, is this on? You're Came talking in? To me, I'm going to talk to
not
you.
I'm not talking to you, man. I'm talking to the people that hit my lead singer
you're
in the head.
You're talking to my people.
Right.
Now, let me tell you what's happening.
You,
man, what's
you're not
happening?
Up
hey!
Oh! No!
Out there, hold it. All that.
No!
Oh,
no, stop it.
No!
You know what's happening?
Happening.
We're partying like you. Hey!
That's really stupid.
Hey, man, you guys do not have to stay on the stage, man. They're not going to hassle us, really. They're not really that. It's really not worth it.
No hassles with anybody in particular. You got to keep your bodies off each other unless you intend love. People get weird, and you need people like the Angels to keep people in line, but the Angels also, you know, you don't bust people in the head for nothing. So both sides are, fucking up temporarily. Let's not keep fucking up.
Oh, that's what the story is here?
Yeah.
Oh, bummer.
Really, yeah. I mean, like, it's scary.
Who's doing all the beating?
Hell's Angels.
Hell's Angels are doing beating on musicians?
Marty got beat up. They've been fighting on the stage.
Doesn't seem right, yeah.
It's really weird, man. It's really weird.
Oh, man.
There's lots of people.
Really?
Get that beer!
Let's get it!
There's so many of you. Just be cool down the front and don't push around. Just keep still, keep together. Oh yeah. Sisters.